I gave you my heart.
Hey guys. Well, I got the sundown, and like I showed you guys last night, so I got home a little bit early. I mean, it's sun's fixing to go down. It's 6:28. I've been home for a couple hours. I had to do a few things around here, plus get cleaned up. Anyway, I was going to show you how this sundown sounds. It sounds pretty good. The dude wants to trade me the two Def Bonce Machete Sports, which they're 750 RMS, just like this sundown. For this sundown and my Scar RP2000, which that Scar RP2000 is brand new. You guys know I only barely used it. Then I bought this. So I want to get another one of these and run either 212s or 215s with the 210 XFLs that I got. Because I'm going to get another 10. I'm going to order it tomorrow. So I think the sundown looks pretty good. But you know one thing about it? When I had the other Smart 3, remember I had the guy, my older subscribers, you guys know, I had that NVX12. Well, when I would, you know, turn it up to not like jamming bass, but, you know, decent bass in the car, I would start smelling that chemical voice coil smell, you know what I mean? Like the burnt voice coil. A lot of people told me that's just because it was brand new. And this thing ain't brand new, but it was just reconed. The guy told me that I got it from right before he gave it to me. Which I thought there was something wrong with this because it had glue all over. This thing was off of it when I got it. This glue that you see right here was all over it. I got it all off. And you guys know the leads, how they were, because the guy did a horrible job with that. But I fixed that. So, but this sub, and it's still warm from earlier, it does the same thing that the NVX did. It gets that, when you turn up the bass, it gets that chemical voice coil burnt smell. It's that weird smell. You guys, if any of you guys have smelt that, put it in the comments. But and the motor got real hot. You know, I know I'm not clipping, but I'm probably overpowering it because I got this at one. This is a dual 2-ohm sub, so it's wired down to 1 ohm to that amp, and I got it set at 54 volts, which is 3,000 watts. But I'm not turning it up like crazy loud neither. I guess I should probably turn the gain down a little bit. So anyway, I'll let you guys hear this. It's not bad. I mean, this box is super small for that. You know, it's got a thick enough baffle now. It's got the I've had to add so many boards to it. It's got the box is made out of oak, but the boards that are on, the two boards on the front, are just pine board. I didn't care because this ain't gonna be no, this is just some temporary shit, you know. But this, like I told you guys last night, this box is tuned to 34 hertz. It's 1.5 cubes. I think that's what this sub, the specs are for this sub. But I don't like these boxes when they're short and stubby. I know they sell a lot of prefabs like that. But even if I have one single sub, I like building a box that goes across the whole back, you know, make it slimmer but longer, you know what I mean? Wider, you know what I mean? Like I had for the NVX. So, but I mean, it sounds good. I couldn't believe it, man. I was, you know, coming home from work tonight and I was jamming on it, a couple songs. I was like, damn, man, for 112, it sounds pretty good. I mean, my 10 XFLs, I had that one that I just blew. But I mean, I used to play it single all the time. I had it in this box and I did some wild shit in this box with that 10. I mean, I don't think that ride's gonna dance. I stuck it in there, but that port ain't big enough. It ain't like my other box. I just stuck it in there anyway. But yeah, it doesn't sound bad. But you know, it is sundown, so it's quality. So, but for a 12, it had this car shaking pretty good. It ain't nothing like how I have when I got the two 10s in here. That's one thing I like about the American bass. Let me say this before I do this little demo of this sundown. The one thing I like, well, it ain't the one thing I like. I like a lot of things about the American bass. The XFLs. I've never had any of the other subs, you know. I've had Scar, I got Scar mid-range, but I've had a Scar DDX. I like Scar's subs. I mean, that DDX was okay, but it wasn't, you know, it couldn't keep up with what the American base I had could. So that's why I ended up sending it back. Now, the VV, what are they, VZX? I know there's ZVX. Those are pretty good. I was thinking about getting ZVX 12s, but I was like, if I'm going to do that, if I'm going to get something that big, like Scar's got the ZVX, I'm just going to go ahead and get another Sundown. I'd rather have Sundown than Scar, personally. Nothing hating on Scar, because I like Scar. I mean, I got Scar mid-range all the way around my car. And I got a Scar amp. Wait, I'm selling it, but I like it. No, I'm not hating on it. It's just not strong enough for my taste. But, yeah, back to what I was saying about the American bass real quick. The American bass, what I like about it is, man, I pushed it with this amp. And I pushed it with the other Smart 3. And I had two other HD Taramps 3Ks. And I'll tell you what, man. Sometimes the motor, I mean, after I jammed it a whole bunch, it might be kind of warm. And you can stick your finger. Because this one, you can't even stick your finger in the pole. But I mean, your pinky finger. But the American bass has got a pole vent big enough. I can stick my index finger in the hole. But, I mean, I guess it's because the way they vent them. I'm not sure, but it doesn't get that hot. And I never smelt the voice coils, ever. Not even on the new one I just got, not the old one that blew. Never, not one time, did I ever smell the voice coil, that chemical smell. So, I don't know, guys. You tell me. I mean, they're rated 1500 RMS, but I mean, even when I overpowered them, I never smelled it. But this, as soon as I overpowered a little bit, you start smelling it. Same thing with the NVX I had. Same thing with the Scar DDX. So, American bass, man, they're tough, good subs, man. I highly recommend them. The XFL series, anyway. I wish I would have went with 12s instead of 10s, though. But I just got the 10 to check it out, and then I ended up liking it. But I do want to get the bigger versions. But I'm just going to get another 10 for now, because I got the box built and all that. And, you know, it's just way more money to start over. So, but for the next two subs that I want, I got to have four subs in all. I could get four XFLs. What do you guys, leave in the comment you think I should do that. Because I could do that. I could order two XFLs for $309. And then I'd have three, and then I'd only need one more. But I was thinking about mixing up the frequencies. I know you do that with different tunings and different boxes, you know. Like on the sixth order, you can have two different frequencies. I understand that. But what I'm saying is I was going to put the two 10s on a wall. I've said this before several times. I just really ain't got time. And I'm trying to get all the stuff together before I do it. But take these seats out. You know, I got plenty of room right here. And once I take that out, I got plywood from my trunk floor as it is. Continue the plywood right to here and have it run down. And then, you know, but actually it'll be right to here. Wherever I can put it on across to make it level. And then put the two 10s here on the wall, though. You know, with a big port in the middle. And then two 12s. Or two 15s up top. That's what I plan on doing. Because I don't really want four 10s. But I mean, four 10s would probably sound good, though. That's a lot of cone area. Tell me what you guys think. I mean, I'm going to end up building it sooner or later. Especially after I get that alternator. That's what I really want to get first, though, is that alternator. After I get this 10 in, the next thing I need to buy is that alternator and the big 3 wire. Because that'll kill a lot of problems right there. It takes power to make power, you know it. I've learned that. Anyway, let's check this out real quick. Let me quit running my mouth. All right, guys, let's check out Blueberry Yum Yum by Ludacris. Make it daddy's trip. Yeah, this is DJ Festival. Think I'ma try something that I ain't never did before on this. Let's go. Yeah.
I have to settle. I'm gonna just be cool cause I don't have to. I'ma continue with my mission, vision for the yum yum. I'ma stop, drop, and roll. Put a wet towel under the door. Don't pass it, I can't take it no more. Somebody take a trip down the road. Hurry, please, that I need some. And how long will it take to get my money? Yes, indeed, I'm a little lost. Try. Off this weed, and I'm full of that. Get out of here, thank you. I ain't in the room to fit the room of the cheeks. And I'm so hungry with the munchies, I'ma eat everything. I'll just get my blueberries together and everything.
Check it out now. We just played that one. But listen to this, fans. Hear them? I mean, they're running good. They're not messing up or nothing. So they're not making no clicking noises or anything. So that's good, you know? And the amp, I mean, it's barely warm, you know? The motor ain't that hot this time. I didn't turn it up that much, though. I was probably turning it up too much on the way home, because you know when you're driving, the bass ain't as loud as when you're sitting still. So, you know, especially like if you're trying to demo something, don't demo it while you're driving unless you got some hellified shit. You know what I mean? My 210s I can, because you feel it. But, I mean, this one don't sound bad even when you're driving, though. I'm just happy I got some bass. But that dude wants to trade me tonight, and if I trade him for this, then really, he gave me them 215 machetes. I couldn't do nothing with them because I don't have a box to put them in, and I ain't got the wood to build it right now. So I'd pretty much, unless I put another board on this and put my American Base 10, the good one, in this box, I could do that. You know, I could play that until the other one comes in, like Monday or Tuesday. But I don't know. Thinking about just keeping my Sundown. And the Scar amp. The Scar amp I might just sell and get the money for it and buy maybe another Sundown or something, because I like it. Let's hear one more song, though. All right. Next one's Phone Light Up. We'll be right back.
So we gon' blow. I go 3 hard in the gun. It get hot on the clip by the fun. Swimming with shots in the tub. Hope you share some.
I'm gonna go get some more.
55 hertz.
I can relax. Don't you get rusted?
What's in the pot? Work.
Push my star. Hit one play. Then I'm on top of her.
Taking on my dick is something that I never seen. I fuck her at that. I'ma need a jig, bitch. Okay, what you tellin'? Say I gotta send it back. Okay, what you tellin'? I ain't playing with you. I already got too many fellas. If I pull a stick,
girl, I wanna see you twerk. I throw a little money, twerk. All right, thank you, good twerk. If you broke, go to work. Make that big twerk. Make that big booty.
Can I push that booty? That booty.
That's it for tonight. Yeah, the Sundown by itself, that single 12 is not bad. It's pretty good. You see, I was trying to poke that rag in that port. It's kind of hard to get it in there. That first song, though, I could get it in there, and it would suck it in there and keep it in there. It was pretty cool. But, I mean, it's just too narrow. I don't make boxes like that no more. You see the box I got now. Big, giant port. You throw a rag right in it and have fun with it all day long. But anyway, that was fun. At least it's some bass. Better than nothing. You know what I mean? It ain't tremendous bass. It's not as good as both my 10s. But, I mean, it's decent for that being in that small box like that. I think it should be in a bigger box, at least 2 cubes. You know what I mean? But eventually, man, I'm going to get this shit right. I'm going to get, you know, all the stuff together. And maybe I'll get... It's getting to be winter time, so we're not going to be working weekends, I heard. So I'll have Saturday and Sunday. I can start, you know, working on tearing these seats out and building this wall here. I'm going to have to do something about this sunroof and all that, too. I mean, it's nice in my videos for the flex, but, you know, when I get the wall in here, I'm going to have to seal all that off, probably put plywood up here or whatever, because I don't give a shit. It ain't like nobody rides with me anyway. Anyway, what do you guys think about that Sundown SA? It's only rated 750. I mean, it ain't too bad. Could be worse. Well, Sundown's good subs anyway, you know what I mean? But it'll have to do for now until I get my 10, that other 10, as soon as it comes in. I'll throw that in here. Anyway, that's all for tonight, guys. I'll catch y'all in the next one. Late.